I am back today with another video. Today I'm going to be making a shirt for my cousin for her birthday. I'll include a picture of the shirt. It is a design that she found online. I do not like to sell other people's work, so I'm not going to sell her the shirt. I'll just make it for her. Sometimes what I do is, well, I only do stuff like this for family members, but sometimes I'll have them buy the vinyl so that I can make the shirt for them, but I do not sell other people's work. Like, I don't know, that's just not something that I like to do. So I will insert the picture so you guys can see what the shirt looks like. But I'm going to go ahead and get started with getting everything that I need on the shirt. I'm going to try to get a font that's as close as possible to what I see on the shirt. But if I can't, of course, find exactly what it is, I just, you know, still make it somewhat my own anyway. But I want it to be similar so that way she gets what she wants, and it's her birthday, so I want her to be happy with what she's gonna have for her birthday. So I'm honestly not really sure what the font is, but I know it's more of a bold font. So I'm just gonna go through a couple different ones. See, that looks a little more like what I'm looking for. So I'm trying to decide if I want to have them together like this because there's, you know, space in between, or if I should make them individual entities and have them that way. But I can change the letter spacing. See, that didn't change much. Because I don't like to waste any vinyl if I can help it. Trying to think of what height I want it to be. So I'm just going to use the ruler. It's hard to get this in frame, but on the Cricut mat there is a ruler. So I'm trying to guesstimate. Yes, I said guesstimate. About how big I want these numbers. That actually might be okay, but maybe I'll do I'm going to there's a font that starts with the W that I like. And so let's see if I can find it. Wanderlust. I don't always forget what it's called. I have to cut these nails. So I'm pretty sure that on the shirt she sent me, these two words were two different fonts. I'm gonna take a look in a second and verify that just to be sure. So I'm just going to fast forward through some of this. It's just me, you know, figuring out the sizes, or the sizing, better yet, of what I wanted. And then a little bit later on, I realized that I actually wanted to change all the fonts and basically redid everything over. So I'm just going to skip through this. When you're doing this yourself, you know, it's up to you. If you wanted to, you know, do the same thing, that's fine. But whatever you do, you can alter it, you know, to be your own in anything that you do, anything that you make, especially in design space. There's plenty of fonts to choose from. There's free ones as well as others that you have to pay for, but you can always use, you know, different fonts that may be on your system or on your device. And, you know, there's plenty to choose from. So don't be afraid to try new things. Don't be afraid to make things a little bit bigger or a little bit smaller than the idea that you had in your head. You just gotta go for, you know, what you know, or go beyond what you know or what you may be used to. Try something different and just see how it comes out. I'm just gonna leave it like this. And so I'm going to select make it. I should have to turn this on. So I have two mats, and I actually need to move this to this mat, and I'm going to move this to the other mat, because these things are going to all be the same color. So put the word girl there, and I am setting up my mat, which is slightly out of frame, but so I don't have like a full sheet of vinyl. I'm actually using my scraps, so I'm hoping that will be just fine. I'm actually going to put that in the right direction and put it here. And then this one, I'm going to put line. And I also have to mirror this because this is going to be iron on. Because the Y is the only thing that's a little bit lower. Hopefully, then I can just go back and make another Y. So I'll just leave that as is. Okay. So this mat is set. Now let me go to this mat. And I'm also going to mirror this one, so that when I do cut it, it'll be fine. But I want to cut this one first. Okay, I'm not purchasing anything. Oh, wow. Kayla, I'm recording. So I'm just connecting to my machine. And I will adjust the camera so that you guys can see as soon as we get this rig. Okay. So insert my mat. Yes, Kayla, I'm recording. And let's go cut. Gonna move my machine away from the wall, that doesn't happen. cheaper. This is the shirt. It's a size large women. Let's have the number 36 and say that's not bad. Say birthday girl, just step to my desk. Just put up some more fake wood. Thank you. And of course, this is not straight. I'm just, oh God in heaven. This is actually okay. I thought it was not. So I'm not sure if you all can tell, but I had my final slightly Cricut. So it's a little bit of the bottom cut off, but I'm gonna make that work anyway. But yeah. So actually it fits pretty well. Hey Kayla. Close your mouth,
girl. What? Okay. I didn't know how you were filming.
You didn't know how I was filming? On the camera? Bye. Okay, so I'm going to turn on my Cricut Easy Press so that it can heat up. I'm going to move this back a little bit. If you've made it this far in the video, don't forget to like and subscribe. straight, pretty even today, so let's check one more time. So turn it back this way. Double check the instructions for the vinyl, the glitter vinyl, to see how long it says to heat it. Okay, so I don't see, I'm gonna put this down. Okay, so it still says 10 seconds, even though it's much thicker. Okay, so I'm gonna press the 36. Now it's going to touch my other words. I'm okay with that. This doesn't hurt to reinforce what I've already done. But you can do more. Vinyl does shrink, so just know that there's this one looks thick. But just know that if you heat it longer, you may lose a little bit of the size. I may choose a different brown because I don't like this. My design space looks as if. And that leaves it right on the collar. And ironing on the collar is like ill. Stressing me out now. if I figure out another crown or just resize the one that I already used to make it look good, I'll show it. But otherwise, this is what the shirt is going to look like. Stresses me out a lot. Okay, so I don't know. I may be back in a few minutes. So I'm going to try and cut this that I already have. I don't know. I mean, I'm not going to use it, so I mean, what's the worst that can happen? If it gets messed up, then it's just messed up. So we're just gonna try to find some of this. So this is the final look. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. See you next time.